In this part 2 of step by step of cervical corpectomy, we will talk about how to do discectomies. So before you plan your discectomy, it is important to go to the CT scan, to the MRI. You need to rule out any variation in the anatomy or any variation of vertebral artery. We will start with C4, C5 discectomy. The right side of the screen is the cranial end. The left side of the screen is the caudal end. The surgeon is standing on the left side of the patient. Number 11 plate is used to start the discectomy. The unciform process determines the lateral limit of the discectomy. Once the outer annulus has been cut, then the curettes can be used to remove the hard disc in cases like this one. It is important to remove any anterior osteophyte which can be pre-seen on the CT, because any anterior osteophyte will obscure your vision in order to reach the middle and the inferior part of the disc. Once the osteophytes are removed, the disc space is distracted over this distractor pins. This will make it easy to access the disc space, which is narrow in this case. Once you have distracted the disc space, these high speed burrs can be used to burr out these collapsed discs. It is important to continuously irrigate while using this high speed burr, as it prevents the thermal injury and will remove any debris which comes out of using these burrs. Once the disc space has been completely burred out, the next step will be to look for posterior osteophyte, as in these cases the posterior osteophyte will obscure you from reaching the posterior longitudinal ligament. A high speed burr can be used to remove the superior and the inferior osteophytes. Any bony bleed which you might encounter in these cases can be stopped by using the bone wax. Bone wax is an excellent tool to stop bony bleeds in these cases. Once the osteophyte had been completely thinned out, a 1 mm ronger can be used to safely remove the remaining of the osteophyte. It is important to completely remove the inferior osteophyte, as the superior osteophyte will come out as part of the corpectomy as well. Most of these cases will have a central compression, and the PLLL is thickest at the center. So it is safe to approach the PLLL laterally. A ballpoint probe is placed between the PLLL and the dura. The PLLL is lifted up and a 11 number blade can be used to cut the PLLL safely. Then a 1 mm ronger can further be used to remove the rest of the PLLL and any remaining osteophytes. This is an important step of the surgery, and it has to be performed very meticulously. the entire breadth of the posterior longitudinal ligament has to be removed, it is important to see that the PLL is removed from uncus to uncus so that the cord can be completely visualized. Ballpoint probe can be used to check for any compression of the cervical foramen, and any osteophyte or any PLL remaining in the foramen can be removed using a 1 mm Rontgen. Both the right and the left lateral foramen has to be decompressed. The uncus can be undercut to make sure that these foramen are decompressed. Before you finish your discectomy, it is important to check that all that four corners has been decompressed completely. A ballpoint probe is very safe to confirm the adequacy of the decompression. This is the end of the discectomy and the dura at C4-5 is completely decompressed. The next step is to do discectomy of the proximal level, which is the C3-C4. The retracted blades are now shifted to the C3-C4 level. It is important to again read and confirm the MRI and the level. The same steps are repeated for the C3-C4 discectomy. A high-speed burr is again used to remove the posterior osteophyte. Once the posterior osteophytes have been completely removed, the distractor blades are opened to distract the disc space between C3 and C4. Again, the ballpoint probe is placed underneath the PLL and 11 number blade is used to cut the PLL, and then a 1 mm Rontgen can be used to safely remove the remaining part of the posterior longitudinal ligament. It is important that the PLL is removed from uncus to uncus and the cord is completely decompressed. Before we end the discectomy, again the adequacy of the decompression is confirmed using a ballpoint probe. Now the distractor pins are shifted to the C3 and C5 and we are ready to start the C4 corpectomy. This is the end of part 2. In part 3, we'll see how to perform a corpectomy.